We are back for our second presentation today, and I believe it's about hurdling, it looks like. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, so I'm Maggie.
And I'm Michaela, and we are doing the calculus in hurdling. So some history of hurdle races. The 100-yard hurdle races appeared around 1830 and were run over heavy wooden barriers. In 1880, the distance was changed to 110 meters. The 400-meter hurdle race was introduced in about 1860 at Oxford. The 110-meter hurdle race was introduced to the Olympic Games in 1896 after lighter weight hurdles were introduced. And the 400-meter hurdle race was introduced as an Olympic sport in 1900. And that was all just for the men's side of it. For the women's side, the first women's hurdle race, like official race, occurred in 1926 and was a distance of 80 meters. The 80-meter hurdles became an Olympic event in 1932. In 1969, the distance was changed to 100 meters, and that's the standard for today. And then women began running the 400-meter hurdles at the Olympics in 1984. And here are some pictures of hurdlers. So this is a picture of 1928 men's 110-meter Olympic hurdle race. And as you can see, they're wooden, and they have a bar going on either side of the hurdle. And then over to the right is Babe Diedrichsen, and she won the gold in the 1932 Olympics, and it's still wooden with the bar on either side. And then here's the women's 80-meter hurdle race during the London Olympics in 1948, and it has the newer L-shaped hurdle so that when you hit the hurdle, it will go down with you, whereas these ones, if you hit it, it doesn't really move, and so you're more likely to fall and hurt yourself.
So why we chose hurdling. So Michaela's like actually in track and she actually does hurdles and I'm not. So we wanted to compare and see what our difference is if we do hurdles. And I also wanted to see if I could actually like jump a hurdle because I've never done that before. So yeah.
And Maggie was in track in middle school.
Oh yeah, I was in track in middle school. So that's something. Yeah. I said our objectives, so we wanted to compare. So that's what I thought I was going to end up, but it was fine. So then we wanted to compare my velocity to Michaela's velocity over the hurdle, as we took off, as we're directly above the hurdle, and while we're landing. And then we also want to compare Michaela's arc length over the hurdle to mine over the hurdle.
Okay, so first we ran over one hurdle. So that's me going over the hurdle, and I can loop it so it goes. So that's me going over one hurdle. And then we put that into capstone and it plotted. We tracked my hips because that's like the center of your mass. And then for the reference, like they said, they had to redo the reference to the height of the person. We did our reference scale to the height of the hurdle, which would turn out to be 0.84 meters. And then since the Y motion is different from the X motion to get an overall velocity function, we had to find the position function for Y and X separately and then create an overall velocity function. Kind of like in Claire's presentation, if you remember that. So then we tracked my Y position to time, and we got a position function for that. And for a line of best fit, we chose a polynomial function. And we got an equation of 0.741 plus 3.8t minus 12.5t squared plus 12.9t to the third minus 3.72t to the fourth. And we took the derivative of that to get dy over dt equals 3.8 minus 25t plus 38.7t squared minus 14.88t to the third. And then we took a look at my x position. So that we took my x position in respect to time, and we still use the polynomial function for that. And then we got x of t equals 0.00593 plus 5.22t minus 3.83t squared plus 9.92t to the third minus 6.5t to the fourth. And then we took the derivative of that to get dx over dt equals 5.22 minus 7.66t plus 29.76t squared minus 26.28t to the third. And then to get our overall velocity function, we took the reciprocal of dx dt, So dt over dx times dy dt to get dy over dx, which would be our overall velocity function. And then we calculated that out down here, and then we got our overall velocity function at the bottom. And then we took a table of velocity. So we looked back at our video of me going over the hurdle. And right when my foot, my last foot takes off, which is at 0.00 seconds, we plugged that into our velocity function to get to find out that I was going 0.479 meters per second. And then right above the hurdle, I was at 0.299 seconds. And we plugged that in and found out I was going negative 0.125 meters per second. Right when my first foot touches the ground after I'm going over the hurdle, it was 0.431 seconds. So we plugged that in to find out I was going negative 0.183 meters per second. And then as I start running to the next hurdle at 0.763 seconds, we plugged that in to find my velocity to be 0.128 meters per second. And you can see that's positive, and then it goes becomes negative as I go over the hurdle and then positive again, because as I'm running to the hurdle, my velocity is increasing. And then as I go over the hurdle, I lose momentum, I lose speed, and then I, as I start running to the next hurdle, I start. And then we found an arc length going over, of me going over the hurdle. So we have the equation of the arc length. And then we took from right when I first jumped to go over the hurdle at 0.006 seconds to right when I land to at 0.431 seconds to my arc, to find that my arc length over the hurdle was 0.372 meters. And that's just a little representation of us during this project.
Was it going very well though?
We had some shoulders. And now we have minis.
So now it was my turn to do the hurdle. And so it started off with Rod brought out like the mini hurdles because I was terrified just to go over the big one. So it looked like one of those first pictures like with the Olympics. It was like that bar. It was scary. But then I worked my way up and actually jumped a hurdle. So it was really exciting. Then here's my video. Well, that's interesting.
Okay. So that's me going over the hurdle.
I was really excited I finished it. Okay, you can go next. That's okay. So here, all like where my hips was, because Gabby did like that center of gravity, and so you can see the difference between mine and Michaela's. Do you want to go to the next one?
Yeah.
Then, so if you notice the difference between our two and someone who actually does hurdles and who doesn't, Michaela's is a lot more smooth and consistent. Mine's kind of
sporadic.
Yeah.
More sporadic.
But yeah. So then I did the same thing as Michaela, and we put all of our things into capstone. But my graph was a little more sporadic, as kind of seen. So the polynomial was a little bit off, but it was still the line of like best fit because the other ones weren't working. So then our equation for the y up and down is 0.855 plus 3.48t minus 11.3t squared plus 11.3t cubed minus 3.62t to the fourth. That derivative of that to the velocity is 3.48 minus 22.6t plus 33.9t squared minus 14.48t to the third. Same thing with the time with respect to x, x with respect to time things, that our x of t is 0.0476 plus 2.26t plus 2.18t squared minus 2.77t to the third plus 0.903t to the fourth, and there's the derivative. Can see it? Yep. Oh yeah, and we did use a polynomial for both of like the lines, so it'd be like the same one. And then here's our work for listing all the derivatives and create them back into one velocity function, because again, the two are different, like going forward and up with hurdles, forward or up. And so there is our derivative again of those two. Let's see. Also, we went from Rock Creek to Caribou this time, so our light is completely different. We were really frustrated at this point. So then here's my table of velocity. So we both started at the same spot, and I was faster than Michaela at this point, but then we kind of saw that Maggie got slower throughout the hurdle. So above the hurdle, I was negative 0.277 meters per second. Landing, I was negative 0.410 meters per second. And going to the next one, I was negative 0.196 meters per second. So we also did my arc length from the moment going, like my foot going up to going back down here. Is that equation again? Mine was 0.457 meters.
And these were some thoughts going through our mind during the project, because one, we didn't know we had to continually save, so we lost all of our data and had to restart. Mm-hmm. And then also we realized we were doing it wrong because we forgot that like movement in the x direction is different from movement in the y direction, so we had to go back and redo our work to find the overall velocity function. So we did it quite a few times.
Never saw Michaela in the state of Mike either. It was kind of scary, to be honest.
And then our conclusion, from comparing the tables of our velocities, Maggie actually had more velocity than I did coming into the hurdle at takeoff. And if you look at the videos, you can see that her foot takes off closer to the hurdle than my foot takes off farther away from the hurdle. Like Maggie lost more velocity as she's going over the hurdle, as I didn't lose as much of my velocity as I was going over the hurdle. And I gained velocity more quickly again than Maggie did after the hurdle, as mine was positive and hers was still negative. And then also, Maggie's arc length over the hurdle was higher than mine. One, because my hips are up higher than her hips, so she has more distance over it. And also, her jump was more up and down, whereas mine was more of a smoother going through the hurdle than hers. And then here is a video of showing our runs regularly in slow motion, and then both of them together. Oh, that's wrong.
Oh.
So there's regular. That's Maggie's. And then these are in slow motion.
So see, I'm a lot closer to the hurdle than Michaela gets to the hurdle. My arms are also like way above.
Nice her. Jump over the hurdle.
I know, she actually had a good trail.
She
was good.
I screamed.
And
after
then that's my slow motion to the hurdle.
So see, like Kayla puts her foot there, and then her one foot just keeps going over.
It's so cute.
She actually looks really good in that video. Makes me upset.
And then this is both of us together. So you can see coming in, she's a little bit
cool
in front of me. And then I don't lose as much speed going over the hurdle than she does. And I keep my momentum going after the hurdle quicker and gain speed.
She's just excited she didn't get
killed. And then this is just the opposite of hers, mine ghosted. And then this is an outtake of Maggie going over the hurdle. She clipped it a little bit, but it was good.
Yes. Okay. Question. Okay.